Chapter 10, Bonds and Bond Valuation, Introduction. Chapter 10 provides a comprehensive overview of bonds and bond valuation. Bonds are financial instruments that offer a fixed income stream to investors. When purchasing a bond, investors essentially make a loan to the bond issuer, who agrees to repay the principal amount and pay interest over a specific period of time. Bonds are considered a basic financial instrument and can add safety and diversity to an investment portfolio. This chapter explores the characteristics of bonds, the different types of bonds, and the relationship between bond prices and interest rates. Learning objectives. By the end of this chapter, you should be able to 1. Understand the characteristics of different types of bonds, such as government bonds and corporate bonds. 2. Determine the value, or price, of a bond using various methods. 3. Differentiate between discount and premium bonds. 4. Analyze the relationship between bond prices and interest rates. 5. Calculate bond yields. Key points. Bonds provide a fixed income stream to investors and can be categorized into government bonds and corporate bonds. Government bonds, such as U.S. Treasury bills, are considered safer due to their backing by the government. Corporate bonds carry more risk as their value depends on the creditworthiness of the issuer. Bond valuation involves calculating the present value of the par value at maturity and the periodic coupon payments. Bond prices and interest rates have an inverse relationship. Floating rate bonds have variable interest rates tied to benchmark rates in the economy. Deep discount bonds, like zero coupon bonds, experience greater price changes with interest rate movements. Real-world application. Understanding bonds and bond valuation is crucial for investors looking to diversify their portfolios and generate a fixed income stream. By analyzing the characteristics of different types of bonds and their relationship with interest rates, investors can make informed decisions about their investments. For example, if you expect interest rates to rise, you may choose to invest in floating rate bonds to mitigate the risk of declining bond prices. On the other hand, if you seek safer options, government bonds with their lower risk profile may be more suitable. By applying the concepts learned in this chapter, you can navigate the bond market more effectively and make informed investment decisions. Conclusion: Chapter 10 provides a comprehensive overview of bonds and bond valuation. By understanding the characteristics of different types of bonds, the relationship between bond prices and interest rates, and the methods for pricing bonds, you can become a more knowledgeable investor. Whether you are considering government bonds for their safety or corporate bonds for their potential returns, the concepts covered in this chapter will help you make informed investment decisions. So dive into the world of bonds and enhance your investment portfolio with this valuable financial instrument. Thank you.